We have known each other for about 16 years and 6 months.
We met at his cousin Yolanda's house. I had went over there to visit her, and she got tired, and she asked him to take me home.
And I took her home, and we exchanged phone numbers.
I think it was kind of like a slick little hookup. I'm like, okay, that's kind of weird. But then we didn't call each other right away. It was like some weeks later, and then we start talking on the phone.
Our first date was a late movie. We went to go see Dracula.
After the movie, we all decided to just go by Wendy's to get something quick to eat.
I knew that she was the one when we sat down and shared some thoughts. I told her that my next girlfriend would be the woman that I would marry. And she actually told me the same thing. So at that point in time, I knew that she really was the one.
And then also my mom liked him, and she never liked any of my boyfriends. So I kept trying to find something I didn't like about him just because my mom liked him. And I couldn't find anything, so I kind of knew he was the one.
I never could make a decision when I wanted her to marry me. I just prayed to God about it, and then just said, when it was time, let the words come out my mouth.
I had no idea he was gonna propose. It kind of caught me off guard because we hadn't been dating that long.
When I proposed to her, we was at home, at my house, and had just got through eating dinner, watching television.
He went to his drawer and got the ring out the drawer, and he turned around and he was like, will you marry me? And I was like, stop playing. You know, I thought it was a fake ring.
Started laughing about it. She thought it was a joke. And I said, no, I'm for real.
And then I was like, I hope you ain't took a ring back from another girl and trying to give it to me. And he's like, no. So I kind of like disregarded it at first. Well, I did my mom a birthday party, and she had called me, and she was like, did Sante propose? And I was like, propose? What are you talking about? She's like, oh, maybe I shouldn't have said anything. So then we kind of just like, I was like, were you serious when you did that the other day? He was like, yes. I was like, oh, okay, well, yes.
My favorite thing about my spouse is that she is truthful and she supports me.
My favorite thing about him is that I can count on him and depend on him. Even if he's upset with me or I've done upsetting him, he'll always, whatever I need, he's gonna make it happen. He comes through and I know he's gonna be in my corner regardless.
Nothing's never the same. I mean, we are very spontaneous. We can try to plan on going somewhere and it doesn't work that way. It just, at a spur of the moment, we can change and do something else, or if we decide to just want to lay around the home and just relax, we'll do that.
Only Udonis can make me mad and smile at the same time.
Only Shay can make me smile when I'm upset or mad.
My best marriage advice came from my former first lady, Marianne Williams. On the day of my wedding, she pulled me to the side and she said, don't be in a rush to have kids, enjoy your husband first. And we did that. We enjoyed our first 5 years together.
I learned about marriage that it is always an ongoing process. You have to stay communicating with one another. You have to always keep God, you know, in your marriage.
What has changed since me and Udonis got married is our communication. We communicate more now, and we just learn to just have each other's back.
We've developed more with God. Another thing is when we left the family, you know, we were able to look to each other for more help versus always being around the family and talking to the family about something.
I would say the best moments in our marriage was when we got stationed away from family when he first switched from the Marines to the Army. We got our first duty station in Texas. We had to learn to depend on each other more so than having family and friends there. It kind of made us get more closer and more solid.
I guess we became more, we was already adults, but became more dependent on one another. I see our marriage in the next 15 years continue growing, continue believing in God, being better, depending on one another more, growing financially.
I see our marriage in the next 15 years. I see us blessed abundantly in the favor of God over our lives. in the future, I hope we always remember to just keep God in the midst of our marriage and in the midst of our family. Just as long as we have God, everything will work itself out.
Like Shafika said, just keep God first. As long as you keep God first, everything will take its course. Mm-hmm.